was filed in court. Of course, motion to quash is different from bill of particular, as we discussed last night, because bill of particular is a remedy granted to the accused for the purpose of asking the court to specify the complaint or informations, the allegations of the complaint or information filed against him or her. So the purpose of bill of particular to enable the accused to prepare a valid plea and valid defense. That is why the court will ask or order the prosecution to specify the alleged defect of the allegations in the complaint or information. So this is in consonant with the rights of the accused under trial or during trial, the right to be properly informed the nature and the cause of accusation. Ang motion to quash is different, though we understand that motion to quash is a remedy granted before entering plea. So that is why at any time before entering his plea, the accused may move to quash the complaint or information. So to simplify ang motion to quash daybay, i-file nimo sa dili pa ka basahan, sa dili pa ang arraignment. So ang purpose nimo is to first for the court to dismiss the complaint or information filed against the accused. Now take note the forms and contents of motion to quash. So most likely the motion to quash must be in writing. So dili siya pwedeng verbal lang nimo nga i-request sa korte or orally. And of course this is signed by the accused or his counsel. And of course they will state the legal ground, the factual and legal grounds or purpose why the accused through his counsel asking the court to dismiss the complaint or information. So take note, the court shall consider no ground other than those stated in the motion to quash, but take note except lack of jurisdiction over the offense charge. So example by lack of jurisdiction over the open charge, like for example, if the crime committed by public officer in relation to the performance of their public functions or duties, most likely, generally, this is under the jurisdictions of the Sandigang Bayan. That is why if the case is filed before a regular court in the RTC, so most likely the RTC will dismiss the or quash the information. For what ground? Lack of jurisdiction. Okay. Then take note. So the grounds. What are the grounds of motion to quash? So take note. One of the grounds of motion to quash that the facts charged do not constitute an offense. So pag misgot galit ang the facts that the facts charged do not constitute an offense, meaning on the face of the complaint or information, it has no charge or it has no offense or crime established. Mura na siya kung nag-file ka og complaint or information ang file name is robbery, but by reading or looking into the face of the information, you cannot come across the allegations of the robbery. So, muna ang imong buhaton is imong pa-dismiss, ipa-quash nimo. So, mag-motion ka. The second is the court trying the case has no jurisdiction over the open charge. So, that is why ato na nang gipasize ka ganina. So, meaning, ang korte nga nag-trial sa or gipahil ang kaso, wala sa jurisdiction. So, most likely, what is the effect if the court trying the case has no jurisdiction? So that would result to in all and void. So manang mingunta nga, it has no effect. Then, the third one is the court trying the case has no jurisdiction over the persons of the accused. Di ba? So na walay jurisdiction ang korte na nagtrial sa over the persons of the accused. Now, ang pangutana, when may the person, when may the court acquire jurisdictions over the persons of the accused? So, take note, the court can acquire jurisdiction over the person from the time nga gi-file nimo ang complaint or information, or ikaduha, kung naay voluntary surrender. So, maunang makaingon ka now nga the court trying the case has jurisdictions over the offense. That is why if you notice nga kung wala gali complaint gi-file, wala information, wala ginay jurisdiction ang korte. So, maunang kung muadto ta sa atong criminal justice system, so kung wala complaint nga gi-file nimo sa office sa fiscal, wala jurisdiction ang office sa prosecution. Likewise, kung wala information or complaint nga gi-file before sa korte, wala ginay jurisdiction ang korte. Munang the court can acquire jurisdiction from the time or the moment nga gi-file na ang information sa korte. Munang muabot na rin ta sa third pillars of criminal justice system. Parihara gyapon na siya nga kanus aman ma-acquire ang jurisdiction sa accused or sa convict by the jail or by the prison. So the moment kanaan ay conviction by final judgment. Kung wala gali conviction, most likely they cannot impose penalty. So wala na siya what is the basis for the prison to receive the person for custody, for rehabilitation. Most likely na ay final judgment. Munang na ay gitawag na to nga mitimus. So, dapat na siya. Then that the officer who filed the information had no authority to do so. Di ba? Wala siya'y authority. Oh, so take note, balik ta sa Rule 112, who are person authorized to conduct preliminary investigation, most likely ang fiscal or prosecutor. Therefore, who must prosecute the criminal action? So balik ta sa Rule 100 din, that all complaint or information shall be filed under the control and directions of the fiscal or prosecutor. Though it admits some exception in areas nga walay fiscal, walay nang mingon na yung the offended party, the peace officer, and other public officer in charge with the law violated may prosecute the case. So, pwede sila. So, muna sila ay makita na ito nga exception. Now, of course, na po'y ikalima na to, that it does not conform substantially to the prescribed form. So most likely, na ay standard nga form ang motion to pass. So nagya po na sila. So muna, kung dili ta mo comply, what are the prescribed form for motion to pass? So pwede na, sa information rather, so pwede na siya nga i-dismiss ni mo or mag-file ka og motion to pass. Then that more than one offense is charged except when a single punishment for various offenses is prescribed by law. So, monang, as a general rule, in every single complaint or information, so, nagin na say only, it will only charge one corresponding crimes or offense. So, isa ragin na siya kabok. Like, for example, people of the Philippines, plaintiff Berson Juan de la Cruz for the crime of robbery, ragin na siya. Dili gina pwede nga imong ibutang dia for the crime of robbery, estapa, physical injury. So dili na siya pwede. Manaingon niya that more than one offense is charged except when a single punishment for various. So though it admits the exception, kanang gitawag na to nga complex crime. Di ba? Manaingon niya or special complex crime. Nga pwede ka mag-file og information for two or more offenses. But that is the exception nga when they law punish two or more offenses. So, manayon nga, when a single punishment for various offenses. So, may tabo na. The most common example na is kanang robbery with homicide. So, manayon nga, Article 294 provide penalty, single penalty or punishment for robbery with homicide for various offenses. So, take note of that. Then, of course, as you encounter in Article 48 of the Revised Penal Code. So, the in case of complex crime. Then, that the criminal actions or liability has been extinguished. Diba? From the word extinguished, meaning nahanaw na. So, munang kung add to ta sa Revised Penal Code na to in relation to your correction, Natay topic dito sa Article 89 nga how criminal liability is extinguished. So, munang makadungog ka dito, una is by date of the convict. Di ba? By service of sentence. By amnesty, by absolute pardon. By prescriptions of crime, by prescriptions of penalty, and of course, merit of the offended party. So, those are some example nga ma-extinguish ang imong criminal liability. Like for example, gipailan ka og kaso, di ba? Pero in which that case, gipail sa imo information, nga imo nang naservisyuhan. So, munang na-prescribe na ang crime na gipail sa imo by service of sentence. Or, pwede po siya nga for a period of pila katuig. Like for example, for crimes panisabol by reclusion perpetua, death reclusion perpetua, and reclusion temporal, prescribed siya for 20 years. So imagine nimo ang imong isoon gipatay last 1990 pa. Oh, so orbutan lang nato la 2000. Oh. So sa 2000 gikan karon 20 years nakapin siya kay 2022 na 2021 naman ta. So wala nimo gi-file ang complaint or information nga murder. So unsa may tabo sir kung karon pa nako gi-file? So generally na prescribe na siya because nilapse na ang 20 years nimo. So ang imong buhaton if you are the accused gi-charge ka, so ang imong remedy is mag-file ka og motion to quash. Then that it contains averment which if true would constitute illegal excuse or justification. So sahay matong tanahon na ay kanang gitawag nato nga di ba kanang concept nato sa Article 11 or even Article 12, di ba? So manang kung atong tanahon dito na ito mga justifying circumstances. So most likely kung ato na siyang tanahon, so dili na gid siya mapwede nimo nga kuan nga file. So sa may what will be your remedy? So your remedy is magpwede ka magfile of motion to quash or that the accused has been previously convicted or acquitted of the offense charge. So morning gitawag nato nga double jeopardy or the case against him was dismissed or otherwise terminated without his express consent. So kung ano na siyang tanawon, the most common example lagi dira is that last 2015 gifailan ka og kaso. So most likely kay correctional penalties man, so not more than 6 years. So ang jurisdiction na sa MTC. So of course convicted ka, gisentensyahan ka og 6 months, 1 day to 2 years. So ang imong gibuhat, wala ka nag-apply provision, imong giservisyuhan. So after 2 years, granting na convicted ka 2015, so pagka 2017, na-discharge ka. Meaning na kagawas na ka. Kaya na-servisyuhan na. So what is the effect, sir, kung gipailan ko og pa the same crime or the same act in which I was previously convicted? So ang imong remedy dira is mag-file ka og motion to quash. On what ground? Because of double jeopardy. Or kung wala man galing ka na convicted, na-acquitted ka. Possibly man na. Gipailan ka, but after the during the promulgations of judgment, the court found out that you are innocent. So, acquitted ka. So, dili gyapon siya pwede. Or the case was dismissed. Oh, gi-dismiss ang kaso. Or otherwise terminated without his express consent. So, mama na siya discussion sa double jeopardy. So dili na pwede nga pailan ka o kaso. So ang imong remedy ayo nag adto og arraignment. Ayo na paghulat og basahan pa ka. Ang imong buhaton is you have to avail parole 117. Now di ang pangutana direkta ni sir, what is the effect sir kung dili ko magfile og motion to quash? Di ba? Mamanay bantayan nato pod. So take note sir, bantayan nato kung dili galit mo file og motion to quash before entering plea or before arraignment, it is deemed waiver of your rights. So bantayan na nimo siya. So ato lang na siyang lakbayan sa balikan na nato under 609 mo na ingon niya for failure to move to quash or to allege any grounds thereto. So mo na ingon niya. So ang imo kunong kuan dia is waiver na siya. Shall be deemed waiver of any objection. But take note there are grounds under motion to quash nga dili siya pwede ma-waive. So bantayan na ninyo ang paragraph E, paragraph B, paragraph G and paragraph I in section 3. So unsa day mahitabo na sir? So meaning even after arraignment you can still in, use that as your affirmative defense in order nga ang kasong gi-file sa imo is i-dismiss nimo siya. So take note, the failure of the accused to assert any ground of emotion to quash before he pled to the complaint or information, either because he did not file a motion to quash or failed to allege the same in said motion, shall be deemed waiver of any objection. So as a rule, to simplify that, so gi-waive nimo imong katungod. But take note, there are grounds nga dili ma-waive. So muna nga, ang una dira is, of course, paragraph 1 does not constitute an offense. Then the court trying the case is wala siya ay jurisdiction. Then ang letter G dia is katong barred by prescription. Then ang last dira is katong concept sa double jeopardy. So take note ha, kung ang pangutana, kung sa'y may tabo, kung dili ta mo file o motion to quash before arraignment or before entering plea, so as a rule, it is waiver. Siya, waiver. It is the waiver of your right to make an objection. So exception na grounds nga dili ma-waive. So that is why you have to in, remember also what are the grounds nga dili siya ma-waive. Now, take note this provisional dismissal. Di ba? Kung say provisional dismissal, sir, take note nga kung mag-file ka og motion to quash, i-dismiss gali ang kaso, ang information. So muna natin tayo kitawag na pag ma-dismiss siya, sir, so tanaw na to ang period or time kano siya sige dismiss na naman. Because if that provisional dismissal mula pa siya og 1 year in the MTC or 2 years in the RTC, so it shall be deemed nga gitawag na to siya nga mahimong permanent after the lapse of 1 year, after the lapse of 2 years, as the case may be. So muna sa ibot pasabot diri sa section 8, muna ingon niya, a case shall not be provisionally dismissed except with express consent of the accused and with notice of the offended party, because most likely that is the requirement. Oh. So the provisional dismissal of an offense is punishable by imprisonment not exceeding 6 years. That is why I address that to MTC. Kay dili man siya mula pasok 6 years or fine of any amount or both shall become permanent 1 year after issuance of the order without the case having been revived. So example by ang kaso gi-file nimo sa MTC. Ang problema dira is that wala jurisdiction ng MTC because most likely more than 6 years man na siya. So unsa may tabo dira, so gi-dismiss siya. O pero pila'y penalty sa crime. So more than 6 years man siya. Mano niya, the provisional dismissal of an offense is punishable by imprisonment. More than 6 years, their provisional dismissal shall become permanent after 2 years. So that is why you are given 2 years to refile. Oh, kay wala may jurisdiction. So, kung sa ibot pasabot na na, so ipile din mo dito sa RTC kay mo man ang naay jurisdiction. So, kung wala ni mo gi-refile na siya after 2 years, so mahimo siyang permanent. So, unsa may tabo kung ang dismissal mahimo na siyang permanent. So, that is equivalent to kung sa man siya acquittal. So, therefore, you cannot refile the case after because that would now be sa man siya grounds for double jeopardy. That is why this section 8 by is also a favorite question in the board exam. You have to remember kanus a mahimong permanent ang dismissal kung gi provisionally dismiss ya or temporary in the MTC or in the RTC, or to simplify, if the penalty for the crime is more than 6 years or less than or not exceeding 6 years. Take note of that. Kay ang term gamit is not exceeding man, so 6 years below. 6 years and below. Pag 6 years and 1 day na, so that is after 2 years. That is why, to simplify, RTC and MTC. So that is the same equivalent nga discussion. So take note of that. So muna na rin siya. In summary. So time to move to quash anytime before entering plea. What is the effect if you will not file within before entering plea or arraignment? So, ngayon niya, it is a deem waiver. But what are the grounds which cannot be waived? So, katong gisgutan nga upat. So, does not constitute an offense that the court trying the case over the offense has no jurisdiction, that the penalty or the offense has been extinguished or prescribed, then double jeopardy has attached. So, ang provisional dismissal na yun, pag more than 6 years, di ba? After 2 years from dismissal or not exceeding 6 years or not more than after 1 year from dismissal. So, take note the topic of motion to quash. Okay. Now, how about pretrial? Kanusta mahitabo ang pretrial? Diba, what are the purpose or what is the purpose of pretrial? Diba? So, mama nang atong tanahon, kumubalik ta sa arraignment, kanusta mag-start ang arraignment? When is the period of arraignment? So, from the time that the court acquire jurisdiction. So, kanusta man siya basahan? So, mingon siya within 30 days. Sulod lang sa 30 kaadlaw. Unless the law provide shorter period. So sir, during sa arraignment sir, the accused enter a plea of not guilty. So unsay may mahitabo mo nang maingon dayon ang judge, considering that the accused entered a plea of not guilty, then we will set the schedule for pretrial. Mo nang diha mahitabo sa korte kay maingon man ang akusado nga maingon man ang court after gibasahan siya. So unsa may ikasulti nimo sa imong sumbong? How do you enter your plea? So man ang maingon dayon ang accused, kung kita ang akusado, plea not guilty, judge or your honor. So kay nag-plea not guilty man ta, maadto gid ta og trial. Pero sa dili pa ta maadto og trial, na patay pre-trial. Why? Because pre-trial is mandatory in criminal cases. Oh. So kanusa man mag-pre-trial? Mapunay atong tubagon. Now, ang pre-trial, of course, ang pre-trial is to simplify the order of trial, to speed up the dispositions of the case. So, ang pre-trial, mahitabo, within 30 days, di ba? Manengon niya, after arraignment, within 30 days from the time that the court acquired jurisdiction. So, meaning, after the accused enter a plea of not guilty, then, within 30 days from the time within 30 days from the time that the accused enter a plea of not guilty. So, unsa imong reckoning dere, dili kanusa ang gipayil, kung dili kanusa gibasahan ka. Kanusa ka nag-plea not guilty. Oh. So, muna, kung nag-plea not guilty ka karun, so, within 30 days, dapat mag-pretrial ta. So, muna siya dira. So, ang reckoning is kanusa nag-plea guilty ang plea not guilty ang accused. So within 30 days dira dayon dapat mag-pretrial ta. Now what are the purpose of pretrial or what are the purposes of pretrial? So of course one is plea bargaining. Di ba? So mo nang atay gitawag nga plea bargaining mo nang sa naghisgot ta og arraignment na ay gitawag dito nga plea guilty to illicit offense. Mabitang na ingon nga, sir, pwede gyapon dahil mag-plea bargain even kumana ang arraignment. The answer is yes. No. Kaya ang purpose lagi dere is para masyurtin, ma-speed up ang disposition sa kaso. No. Kaya possible man that the accused realize nga, uy, murag di jog ko matalusot na gidani. No. Gravity of the offense. Manang niingon na lang ka nga, sir, pwede ra ba, sir, nga mag-plea guilty na lang to illicit offense. Pwede mo na. Oh. So like for example, from murder to homicide. Hindi na tamo adtong trial. So ang kunon sa akusado nga siya ang nagpatay sa kaso nga murder, pero ang penalty rito is homicide. Mura ko na ingon nga, sir, ang kunon ako nga ako yung nagpatay, pero ayaw ang penalty sa murder, homicide lang. That is why, out of consideration na nag-plea guilty to illicit offense or na-plea bargaining, most likely, i-allow na sa court. Oh. Kaya imagine na muna how long is the period pa kung mwadto ta sa regular nga proceeding. Di ba? Oh. So, muna na siya nga scenario. Then, natay gitawag nga stipulations of facts. Di ba? Sabot-sabutan ninyo ang mga issues, di ba, sa kaso. Like for example, kung kamo ang prosecution, ako ang akusado, Di ba? Ang depensa, sumaingon mo nga, ang kunon ba sa akusado nga ang sunda nga nakuha sa crime scene is iyaha, di ba? So, is the accused or his counsel admit, di ba, that the bulo or the knife recovered in the crime scene, which is allegedly used in the killing of the victim, is owned by him or owned by her. Diba? So, kung imo nang ang kunon ba, maingon lugar ang akusado nga, sir, ang kunon ako, sir, nga kanang kutsilyo, kanang sundang nga nakuha sa crime scene, ako ana. So, nag-stipulate mo, pak. So, maunang maingon dayon nga, ang facts nga imong gi-admit, di ba? Wala man imo gi-deny, gi-admit man imo. So, munang mahitabo dayon nga, kung sa manas siya, no need na nga mag-present ka ang evidence. Muna gitawag na to sa investigation nga admission. So, unsa imong gi-admit dito ang sundang nga nakuha sa crime scene. Wala man ka nag-ingon nga ikaw nagpatay. But ang imo dito is kanang sundang ako na. Hmm. That is admission. So, wala nag-indicate dito nga ikaw ang nagpatay. So, not indicating or involving acknowledgement of guilt, but it's only facts. So, muna na ang mahitabo dayon during sa trial, dili na kinahanglan nga mag-present pagag-witness to establish nga ang knife or ang sundang sa itong example is owned by the accused. Nga naman, because most likely it was already admitted. Hmm. Muna itawag na ito nga judicial admission. So, during trial, dili na mo present ang prosecution o witness to prove nga ang sundang is iha sa akusado. Muna na ang pag, sir, what if, sir, during trial, i-present pa niya ang witness. So, pwede ka mag-object. Why? Because that is already stipulated during pre-trial. Meaning, gisabutan na sa pre-trial nga kanang sundang sa akusado na. So, di na kinahanglan nga inyo pang lalisan. There is no more kanang gitawag nga controversy. There is no need to establish evidence considering it was already admitted. So, di na kinahanglan. So, kung atong tanahon, from that na example lang, na-simplify ng order sa trial. Di ba? Na-simplify na. So, nagamay na. So, muna ang ingon nila nga, how important is pre-trial? Di ba? Oh. Sir, what is the effect, sir, kung dili ni ang kunon? So, pag adto sa trial, so kinahanglan nga, mag-present gid mo witness or evidence to establish nga ang sundang sa akusado. Oh. So, muna ang issue na lang na dito, kung gi-admit niya, whether bagyod nga ang biktima gipatay sa akusado. So, kung ako ang accused, ang issue na lang is, whether or not ako bang gipatay ang or ako ba'y nagpatay sa biktima. Dili na kinahanglan nga unsay gamit sa pagpatay sa biktima kanibang sundan. Di na. So ang issue na lang dira is just present a witness to prove nga ako'y nagpatay. So inanana siya. Oh. Then marking for identifications of evidence of the parties. So muna sa pre-trial na yung pre-marking. Unsay mga ebidensya sa mga party litigants sa prosecution on sa ilang mga ebidensya sa depensa sa accused na gyapon na siya mo nang gitawag ito nga marking, di ba? Then waiver of the objections to the admissibility of evidence, di ba? So waiver of objection, so mo nang rason nga during sa pre-trial, di ba? So pre-trial conference, kung tan-aw ni mo dira nga kuan, i-waive nga mag-object ka sa admissibility sa evidence. So, manayon niya, waiver. Then, modifications of the order of trial if the accused admit the charge but interposes a lawful defense. So, like for example, involving homicide nga kaso, maingon ang akusado nga, sir, tinood ako yung nagpatay. Okay. Di ba, naigitawag na to nga confession. That is equivalent to confession kay ikaw may nagpatay. But, nagdepensa ramon ko, sir. Pero muadto ta sa prita sa arraignment na manay gitawag binato nga but interpose some lawful defenses. So unsay may tabo bay, how do you enter the plea? That is equivalent to not guilty. So therefore, ang order sa trial which ordinarily mag-start gid na siya sa ang burden of proof na sa prosecution in criminal cases. So ang mabali na dayon, ma-reverse ang order. So ang mag-present una og ebidensya ang akusado na ang defense. Nga naman, ilang i-establish nga na ay, unsa man siya, justifying circumstance in the concept of self-defense. So, munang, kung ang sa trial na yun, una mo present ang akusado, iyang abogado or ang defense. I-prove nila nga nag-act sila og Self-defense. Sir, what is the effect, sir, kung they cannot, they will not be able to establish self-defense, so they will be convicted. Di naman isyo ang kinsay nagpatay. Di ba? Dili naman maingon nga ikaw nagpatay, no? Ang issue na lang dira is whether or not nabay self-defense, nabay unlawful aggression. Meaning, ang imong pagpatay sa biktima is in accordance with law because that is the concept of justification, justifying circumstances. Di ba? Suma na siya. Then, such other matter as will promote fair and expeditious trial of the criminal and civil aspect of the case. So, take note the word there is fair and expeditious trial. So, Now, sir, after the pre-trial conference, unsa may tabo, the court will issue the pre-trial agreement. Most likely, sa criminal ba ang pre-trial, doro na may tabo sa office sa clerk of court. So, take note, ang pre-trial agreement by, that is the agreement or admission made and entered during pre-trial conference. So, that is in writing and signed by the accused and counsel. Otherwise, they cannot be used against the accused. So, that is why it should be signed both parties. And take note, the agreement covering the matter referred to in Section 1 of this rule. So, muna itong stipulation of fact. So, muna ito siya. So, muna yun ang natin tayo gitawag nga pre-trial. Na may pre-trial agreement, then the court then magatag og order. Muna ang gitawag din ito nga pre-trial order. Sa pre-trial order, diha na nimo makita, di ba? Pila kabuk witness sa prosecution, pila kabuk witness sa defense, kanos i-present ang testimony sa ilang mga witness, kanos ang direct examination, di ba? So, mo man ang pre-trial order. So, sa pre-trial order, ma-identify nimo, like for example, kung kita ang akusado or ang kita ang complainant, kita ang offended party, so, we are aware nga, kanos ang hearing date na tayong dira. Kinana man sa mga order mo ng reason nga, kung ikaw ang abogado, aware ka nga, kana nga pizza na ang kay mga masaman hearing. So, nana dito na appeal na. Kinsa nga witness ang imong i-present, mo na siya order. Oh. So, muna kita nito pre-trial order. That is one of the reason why, 'di ba if you notice sa trial, sir unsay may tabo sir ang witness nako is i-present nako karon pang katapusan or September pa. The problem is ang witness nako sir is na-COVID. Oh. That is the scenario. 'Di ba? Ang imong witness na-COVID. Niya naay kanang danger sa impending death. Usaw man lang ninyo be, usaw man yung remedy. Or the witness is about to die, mo na, to simplify na lang. Or the witness is about to leave the Philippines. Oh. Ang witness assuming by walay COVID, oh. So ang witness nag-process siya para mo abroad. Ang problema lang ang witness kay napay iyang schedule sa iyang direct examination karong first week sa September. Pero today, naka-receive siya og order sa kuan, iyang request sa iyang employer nga ipa-larga na siya karong katapusan. Assuming by Dubai, imong bulan is at 1 million. Di, lugar ka mo larga. Kaya mingon pa kang sir, na-arab ako'y hearing karong kuan o na ako'y mag-testify pa ko karong first week. Diba? So, imposible man kaya na nga maghulat ka. So, there are situation ngayon na that is why munang kung mo-addo ka dito sa trial, you can take the testimony of the witness ahead on the schedule of the examination. So, una, inyong itik kong advance. Kahit kabalumang ka nga, pag-abot sa September 1st week, wala na din mong witness. So, as early as karon, dapat ato na siya kuhaan o kung saman, testimony daan. So, muna yung nila, you can take the testimony in advance. I-advance ninyo sa schedule sa iyang date sa kung saman, examination. So, muna makita na ito. So, take note the pre-trial agreement. Then, of course, muna na siyang pre-trial order as I speak trial ago. Di ba? So, muna yung niya, after pre-trial conference, the court shall issue an order reciting the action taken. So, sa inyong facts stipulated, the evidence marked, so, muna na makita ninyo. Then, such order shall bind the parties, limit the trial to the matter not disposed of, and control the course of the action during trial. So mo lagi nang ang kung walay pre-trial order ba, wala gi trial nga mahitabo. Kay kaning pre-trial order mo ra ni siya og kanang mapa sa order sa trial. Oh. Wala na siya og kung sa libro pa ni mao ni imong table of contents. Oh. Or kani siya mo ning gitawag na to nga Bible of the case. Diba? So manaingon niya, unless modified by the court to prevent manifest injustice. So manaingon niya, control the course of the action during the trial. And that is the pre-trial order. So muna, ang pangutana na po din dire is that, sir, kanus aman mag-trial? So ang imong reckoning dira is, kanus na-receive ni mo ang pre-trial order? So muna, yung ginayong badayan. Dili jug ka makaingon na mag-trial na kung wala pa pre-trial order. Because again, pre-trial is mandatory. There could be no trial, pre-trial, di ba? Conference. So mo nang ingon nila kanus a magsugod ang trial, so imo nang bantayan. So natay gitawag nga tanawa kanus ani mo na receive ang pre-trial order. Okay. So to simplify, to summarize the rules on pre-trial, so mo ni siya. So take note, pre-trial conference is mandatory. Whether in the MTC or RTC. And what is the purpose of pre-trial? Diba? Conference to expedite the trial. Diba? Where the accused and the counsel agree, the court shall conduct a pre-trial conference on the matter enumerated without impairing, diba, the matter rights of the accused. The rights or the rights of the accused. So of course, ato na nang gisgutan ganina, what are the matter to be considered during pre-trial conference? So that's only a summary. Okay. Now dito ta sa, diba? Of course, what is plea bargaining? Sabot-sabot lang na, di ba? Then, take note, the term pretrial order is an order issued by the court reciting the action taken. Ato naman ang isgotan yung gina. Such order binding the parties limits the trial to those matters not disposed of. Okay. So, muna na inisya bay. Take note, ang trial ba ya? After the accused plead not guilty, di ba? The accused shall have at least 15 days to prepare for trial. O, bantayan din ng 15 days. Pila kadlaw ang gihatag sa accused para ma-prepare siya og trial after nag-enter siya og not guilty? 15 lang kadlaw. Then, ganos naman ang trial. So, muna ingon ako sa inyo kaganina, there could be no trial without pre-trial order. That is why the trial shall commence within 30 days from the receipt of the pre-trial order. So, take note ba ya? So, inaniyang mahitabo ang senaryo. Pumana ang arraignment. Okay, the accused is gitagaan ng 15 days para mo prepare sa trial. Then, kano sa man nagsugod ang trial, sir? Of course, kano sa ni mo na-receive ang pre-trial order? Karun, okay na, kahit tayong takadlaw. Take note, the trial shall commence, meaning magsugod. Take note the term within 30 days. From the word within, sulod sa trial takadlaw. So, sir, kung karon na-receive ang pre-trial order, pwede next week, pwede, kay within man. That is why as a rule, di na, dili may tabo nga more than 30 days. So, bantayan na ito na siya. Kaya kanis siya nga pangutan na. That is why, gi-highlight na ito ng color niya pula because that is a board questions. Okay. Then, continuous trial until terminated. Di ba? So, how long is the period of trial? Take note, kanang pula dira. The entire trial period exceed 180 days. So, take note ha. In no case, dili siya mulapas o 180 days. Muna yung niya, trial once commenced shall continue. Diba para yun? From day to day, as far as practicable. Until terminated. Ang tanong man, it may be postponed. Pwede ma-postpone because dili man na-control. Diba? Like for example, especially karon nga makadungog ka nga one of the employees sa korte is nag-positive. So, expected din na siya nga walay kuan kay mag-kuan pa man na sila, disinfect. So, there are cases nga like that. That is why beyond control. Then, it may be postponed for reasonable period of time for good cause. So, that is why the example there is ang good cause is na nag-positive. The court shall after consultation with the prosecutor and the defense counsel, meaning the party litigants of criminal the case, set the case for continuous trial on a weekly or short any other short-term trial calendar at the earliest possible time so as to ensure speedy trial. So that is why, kung ang pangutana dira, sir, nga no, as much as possible, sir, di from continuous man siya, sir, from day to day. Because we have to observe the, sa man, rights of the accused to speedy trial. So, inyo ilang bantayan na unsay reason nimo reason there is the rights of the accused for speedy trial. Mabitanan kung as much as possible ang trial mahuman isa ka semana pwede. Di ba? Then in no case shall the entire period of trial exceed siya og 180 days from the first day of trial. So of course except otherwise authorized by the Supreme Court. Mo lagi na ingon nila na for good cause. Oh. Mao na ang nahitabo as karon lagi example ang pandemic. Kung naay nagpositive dira sa example sa MTC nga empleyado, di ba? Or naay mga close contact dira. So of course magsulat ka sa Supreme Court nga magwan mo, observe mo o katong sana quarantine nga pila ka adlaw or mag-isolate mo. And of course, mag-disinfect. So, these are mga protocol. Kaya dili man ato i-sacrifice ang kung saan po, safety sa health sa mga empleyado, including na ang mga party litigants because most likely they will appear in court. Then, order of trial. Okay. So, bantayan na ito ni. Kaya importante gani. So, kaganina, nag-isguta nga, ma-modify ang order of trial. Kano sa galito? If the accused admit the charge but interpose some lawful defenses. Maningon niya nga, ma-reverse. Oh. So, bantayan nimo. The trial shall proceed in the following order. Of course, klaro man na siya. Familiar man mo na na. So, the prosecution shall present evidence to prove the charge. And, in the proper case, the civil liability. So, that is why, kisay complainant na to ang prosecution. Oh. So, therefore, it is the burden of the prosecution to establish nga na ay crime nga na commit. Then, ang akusado nga gipailan is moy responsable. Murarago na siya kung mupail mo example robbery sa ako, ang burden of proof nga ako ang nag-commit sa robbery is na sa inyo. Then of course after sa prosecution, muna na ningon niya the accused may present evidence to prove his defense. Muna na tayo gitawag nga adversarial system. Bantayan gina ninyo because we have the unsa man constitutional guarantee that the accused is presumed innocent until contrary is proved beyond reasonable doubt. Mo na reason sa adversarial system. So mo na ingon niya if any arising from di ba the issuance of provisional remedy in the case. Okay. So sa na metabo the prosecution and the defense may in that order so balik puli-puli na dayon. Present rebuttal and surrebuttal evidence. Okay. Then upon admissions of evidence of the parties, the case shall be deemed submitted for decision. So ang pasabot na after ang prosecution nag-present ng evidence, then naghuman na po dayon ang depensa, then human naman. So then muna ingon nila nga, this is now for the court to decide. So muna ingon niya, letter A, atong emphasize balik lang, when the accused admit the act or omission, charge in the complaint or information, but interpose a lawful defense, the order of trial may be modified. So, muna nga itong gi-emphasize. So, that is the only exception na ma-reverse ang order sa trial. Okay. Now, discharge of the accused to be state witness. Oh. Sir, what are the requisites? Muna gitawag na to sa kuan ba yung transactional immunity. Transactional immunity in the sense that the accused entered one of the accused entered into a condition or agreement. Sa may iyang agreement dito nga, i-discharge siya nga akusado para mahimo siyang testigos or witness sa prosecution. Pero what are the requisites? Tanaw na to. Like for example, kung ang scenario na to ba is gipailan ko niyo grabery. Di ba? Ako ra isa. Ma-discharge ba ko? Dili, gina. Kisa naman lay akusado i-discharge. Di ba? So, munang imumantayan dira, when two or more person are jointly charged. So, daghan mo. With the commissions of the offense. Upon motion of the prosecution before resting its case. Sa dili pa sila mahuman. The court may direct one or more of the accused to be discharged with their consent so that they may be witnesses for the state. Ang bot pasabot na for the state is for the prosecution. After requiring the prosecution to present evidence and sworn statement of each, di ba? Proposed state witness at the hearing in support of the discharge, the court is satisfied. That, bantayan niyo na. Di ba? So, bantayan na ito ba? Balik ta. Unsay requisites dira? Una, dapat daghan mo the charge sa krimen. Ikadua, there is no direct evidence available to the people. Di ba? Like for example, by tagaan na mag-senaryo. So, ABCD, gipailan og kaso nga robbery. ABCD. So, upat sa nakabok. Kaning crime nga nakomit ni ABCD, na eyewitness nga nakita ako. So, pwede ba nga si Edire or isa sa upat nila, ABCD, si D, i-discharge para mahimong witness sa prosecution? The answer is no. Nga naman, because na available nga witness. Oh, kisa may available nga witness dito, of course ako, ako yung nakakita agad na sila yung nangrab. Diba? So, manayin mong bandayan. Ikadawa, ay katulo, rather, daghan mo, dapat walay lain nga direct evidence available to the people or to the prosecution. Dapat, kung ikaw gali witness nga i-discharge or accused nga himong witness, i-discharge ka para mahimong kang witness, be sure nga wala ka na convicted for crime involving moral turpitude. To simplify, be sure nga wala kay previous conviction. Because most likely, crimes under the revised penal could involve moral turpitude. Oh. Diba? Then, imong bantayan, ikaupat, be sure nga ang inyong discharge nga accused para mahimong yung state witness, dili siya ang pinaka-guilty, does not appear to be the most guilty. Oh. So like for example, inani ang scenario na to. So robbery A B C D no nang rob. Or si D. Kinsa ini hitabo si D mo nagbaligya sa ilang proceed. So most likely si D is dili siya principal, accessory lang siya. So dili pwede nga inyong i-discharge accessory. Aw ang principal, then accessory niyo ibilin. But what if sir kung ang accessory dili willing? So either of the three principal, ang issue raman dira because na consent. Dili man bot pasabot kay example, sir, upat sila kabog, puro principal. So, maski isa sa ila. Ang issue there is that, be sure nga kung ang mga akusado ng inyong i-discharge, dili, isa siya mo yung nag-affair nga, pinaka-gilsis. Like, for example, by nangawat ko, oh, ang naitabo, ang nagbaligya, si Umiter. So, duharami, gipailan ang kaso. Ako, principal, siya mo yung accessory. So, meaning, ako mo i-discharge nga principal para mo testigos. Dili, pwede. Pero what if, sir, kung two or more mo, puro mo principal, so either of the principal, basta kaya ang requisites mo, masok, makuhan. So na, ma-establish ninyo. So bantayan ninyo na nga requisites. Sir, unsay may tabo, sir, pag-discharge ka. So once nga gi-discharge ka, that will operate your, unsay may gitawag na to, exemption from criminal liability. So manang kung diri sa Section 17, so naatay gitawag dire nga special exempting circumstances. Nga na special man because these are not found in Article 12. So manayon nila nga that is out of consideration. Out of consideration in the sense nga akusado ka, so ni testify ka sa imong mga kauban. But take note, dili but pasabot kay daghan mo automatic ma-discharge. You have to consider the requisites for an accused to be discharged. Sir, what is the effect, sir, kung ang accuser nga gi-discharge after nga discharge siya, dili na siya mo testify? Then, that take note, pwede siya ibalik og charge sa crime. And take note, without prejudice for the crime of what? The crime by? Gi-discharge ka as state witness, akusado, then during sa kuan, wala ka ni testify. So take note ba ya? You will be liable for perjury. Because in this case ba, you have to execute an affidavit. And it is sworn. Ang may tabo na yun, you have to execute an affidavit. Pabita na yun niya. And the sworn statement of each proposed state witness. So that is why, nanumpa ka, na mutistigos ka sa imong mga kauban. Oh. So that is why naana sa affidavit. Pabita na, for that reason, i-exim ka. Nagsabot man mo. Oh. So muna yun lagi niya, sir, unsay may tabo, sir. So, pwede ka i-charge o balik without prejudice sa another crime na ipahid sa imo. And that is perjury. Executions of, di mo saman, false affidavit or false statement under oath offered other than a judicial proceeding or before judicial proceeding. Then, of course, you have to remember this, the morer ba ya? Or the murer? So, naana kay motion to quash, naana kay bill of particular. So, unsa ning the murer to evidence? Di ba? Oh. So, kanus animo ni siya i-avail? Kinsay mo avail? Kanus animo i-avail? Is demurrer to evidence a remedy granted to the prosecution? or to the accused? That is one of the question. Just like, kinsay mo file og motion to kwas? Kinsay mo file og bill o particular? Inyo ginangbantayan ba? You have to bear in mo, ha? You have to remember that. Now take note, the nearer to evidence is a remedy granted to the defense, to the accused. Tanos sa mani mahitabo. During trial, after the prosecution, presented all their evidence. Manayin nila, after the prosecution, raise its case. Ang gut pasabot na lang, raise its case, meaning after the presented all their evidence. Yeah? The court may dismiss the action. So, ano, i-dismiss ko no? Dili na ta mo padayon into trial. Dili na mo padayon ta nga mo present ang defense sa ilang evidence. Because take note sa order sa trial, ang una mo present is ang prosecution. So pag human sa prosecution, of course, kita defensa. What if by kita defensa found out that the evidence of the prosecution, di ba, is not sufficient to establish our guilt beyond reasonable doubt? Kung saan itong buhaton? Di ba? Mora bita na siya sa dula pa na, di ba? Inani. So, nagdula may og shooting ni omitter. Di ba? So, siya'y una itsa. So pag ang amo dito is base of 5 pabula. So kinsay pinakadaghan. So si umiter naguna itsa siya sa kuan humani ang 5. Sa 5 bay duha ra ini shoot. Duha ra. So ako na pudayon. Pag itsa nako primero sulod, ikaduha sulod, pa ikatulo sulod. So meaning ako pang hurton tanan lugar, dili na. Klaro naman siya. Just like what if by after you presented all your evidence, nakita na ko nga di magyapon ko ma, unsa man, napriso. Dili ko ma-convicted nga naman. Insufficient ang inyong ebidensya. Di ba? So, unsa man, imong buhaton. Meaning, you have to present gyapon sa imong ebidensya. Dili na mo nang maingon na lang dahil ka nga judge. Can you decide the case based on the evidence of the prosecution? Mo nang magkuhan ka og demurrer to evidence. Kaya nga naman, insufficient. See, of evidence. From the word insufficient, meaning kulang. Manayangon niya, on its own initiative, after giving the prosecution the opportunity to be heard or upon demurrer to evidence filed by the accused with or without leave of court. So take note the term with or without. Ang gut pasabot na ng with or without by without permission sa korte or sa judge or sa court. Naalan na siya implication by technical implication kung dili ka mananghid. Ngano man, because take note na, if the mirror to evidence is filed without leave of court, meaning without permission of the court, kung i-deny gali ang imong demurrer by, then you cannot present your evidence to prove your innocence. But take note na, muna yung consequence. Pero nag-file gali ka kung demurrer to evidence with permission, with the consent of the court, then, kung gidinay gali ang imong demurrer, then, you are entitled to present your evidence to prove your innocence. Inanim na yung senaryo. Pag-file nimo, with the consent of the court, ni, of course, gi-decide ang sa korte, gitanaw ang ebidensya. Muna, pag-ingon sa korte nga, uy, insufficient manggid ang ebidensya sa prosecution. So, iyang, unsa man, rendered siya decision. Di ba? For acquittal. Di man ma-establish. Pero what if kuniingon ang judge? Sufficient man ang ebidensya sa prosecution para ma-prove ang imong guilt. So therefore, so kay with permission man to, so you are now entitled to present your evidence to prove your innocence. So take note the concept of demurrer to evidence. So muna yung niya dira, basahin na, bato na ganoon. If the court denies the demurrer to evidence filed with leave of court, the accused may adjust evidence in his defense. So that is why pwede ka mo-present. When the demurrer to evidence is filed, take note, without leave of court, the accused waives the right to present evidence and submit the case for judgment on the basis of the evidence for the prosecution. So, muna akong ingon sa inyo nga, kung wala ka nananghid or nananghid ka. So, take note, the motion for leave of court to file demurrer to evidence shall specifically state its ground. Of course, na ganyan ground. And take note, kanusa, and shall be filed within and in an extendable period of 5 days after the prosecution raised its case. So, pila? Of course, 5 days. this lang. The prosecution may oppose the motion within a non-extendable period, pareha gyapon, of 5 days. Kay na ni man siya, di ba nagfile man ta og demurrer. So maingon man na ang korte nga, "Uy, prosecution, unsa inyong kanang concept nga kuan? Kung sa kuan man na unsa inyong ikasulte in layman's, di ba?" So mo-oppose mo. Na maingon jud mo nga, "Uy, strong man among evidence diyan. Sufficient man na para ma-prove ang guilt sa akusado." Di ba? So mo gina inyong most likely nga kuan statement sa korte, so, i-oppose ninyo ang ilang na demurrer. Otherwise, kung dili, most likely you are consenting or accepting ang inyong ebidensya. Di ba? Admitting ang inyong ebidensya is insufficient. So take note the concept of demurrer to evidence. Okay. So, imo na pong namin. If leave of court is granted, okay, ang both pasabot sa leave is, di ba, nangid. The accused shall file the demurrer to evidence, take note, 10 days. The prosecution may oppose the demurrer to evidence within similar period from its receipt. Mana kung mabalik ta dire, kung ang motion for leave of court to file demurrer evidence shall specific state, then non-extendable period of 5 days. Oh. So muna nagtabo, kung gigrant gali siya, gigrant, kaya nang hidmang gawid leave of court, of course na kay 10 days. The order denying the motion for leave of court to file demurrer to evidence or demurrer itself shall not be reviewable by appeal or by certiorari before judgment. So, pag i-deny. So, dili ni mo pwede nga mag-appealar ka. So, take that away. So, kanina ni Sabay na ulahin niya itong slide. Kato ni siyang requisite sa, di ba, state witness. So, necessity of the testimony of the accused nga discharge. There is no direct evidence. Ato naman siyang isgutan. The testimony of that witness is corroborative or material, then does not appear to be the most guilty, of course, katong crime nga wala ka na convicted involving moral turpitude. So muna siya summary. So, of course, what is trial? Examinations of the judge of issues presented in the due course of the procedure. Diba? The trial purpose is to establish the merit of the controversy, whether the accused is guilty or not. Then take note the trial in absentia. Bay, kano sa galit ito mag-isgot ang trial in absentia? So, of course, atong giskutan kagahapon, na after the accused has been arraigned. Then, of course, the accused gitagaan siya og notice, di ba, to appear in court. That is why the accused was duly notified. Then, ang accused wala siya nito nga without reasonable cause. That is why his failure to affair is unjustifiable. So, muna imong bantayan niya. Of course, ang purpose yapon sa trial in absentia is to speed up the dispositions of the criminal cases. Because we will not look into only the rights of the accused. We have to consider also the rights of the prosecution, especially the offended party. Kung sa may tabo lugar kung walay trial in absentia ba? Kaya kung ako with, ako akusado, example, gicharge ko crime, nakabil ko, o di ko mo tungas korte. It could be an strategy, di ba? Ano man dahil og na ako ikikaso gi-file, di pabitaw ko convicted. So, di kumutong ha, para walay trial. So, di man na pwede. Munang ingon nila nga, aw, og di gamutong ha, adi, wala kay mahimo. Magpadayon. So, ang may tabo, i-weave ni mo imong right to present your evidence. Di man kaka-present kay wamang ka. So, kung sa may tabo nila, ang mag-present og evidence ya, ang prosecution lang. Mura lang na siya, guwamang ganito nga ba? Sa may mo i-present mo amang ka. So, ang base underize ang ebidensya sa prosecution. Then, take note what are the effects of trial in absentia. As it was ruled in the case of People versus Landico, the accused waived the right to present evidence and cross-examine the witnesses against him. Muna yung nakausa inyo nga, dili kakapresentar o ebidensya. So, muna na siya. Gibalik ya po na siya. Oh, as a forms of summary na siya. Oh. So, take note ba ya? Demurrer to evidence with leave of court not waiver of right to file evidence. So, 10 day after the parties may oppose. Kung without leave of court, waiver of right to file demurrer, then nakay 5 days, di ba? And other parties may oppose. So, meaning, of course, ang gut pasabot na na kung kita ang prosecution ipakomenta sa judge unsay atong stand as to the demurrer to evidence. Then after trial, so mag-judgment ta. So unsa ning judgment? Of course, this is the adjudication by the court whether the accused is not guilty or guilty or guilty or not guilty as to the crime charge. And of course, penalty and civil liability. So impositions of the proper penalty and civil liability. So if take note ang judgment by, it must be in writing. Di ba? In the language personally and directly prepared by the judge and signed by him. Oh. And unsa ibutang niyo dito? Unsa imo makita? What are the content? So take note, shall contain clearly and distinctly statement of the facts and the law upon which it is based. So meaning, what is the basis why the person is convicted? Most likely on the basis of the evidence presented by the prosecution and in accordance, di ba, of the law nga gi-violate sa accused. So, mo ginay basis dira. Now, what are the contents of judgment? So, take note kanang upat ba ya? What are the content of judgment in case of conviction? Of course, the legal qualifications of the offense constituted by the acts committed by the accused and the aggravating or mitigating circumstances which attended in its commission. To simplify that, the legal basis in which judgment is based. Muna siya. Ikaduha, the participations of the accused in the offense, whether principal, accomplice, or accessories. So this is true only if there are two or more offenders or accused. So kung ikaw ra isa akusado, adi na niibutang na principal ka because obvious na siya because there is only one person charged for crime. Then, the penalty imposed upon the accused. So, unsa man, that ikaw, Mr. Juan de la Cruz, nakitang sadaan sa pagpangawat o ikaw, pag, di ba, sintensyahan sa duha ka tuig nga doon na sa unom ka tuig o ikaw magabayad. No? That is why natin kitawag nga civil liability or the damage caused by his wrongful act or omission to be recovered from the accused by the offended party. So, bantayan niyo muna siya. So, take note, there are only four contents of judgment. The legal qualification in which judgment is based, the participations of the accused, then the penalty imposed, and of course, the civil liability, if any. Di ba? So, bantayan niyo muna siya. So, muna siya. So, in case the judgment is acquittal, so, unsay may tabo, kato, conviction lang to. So, kung ang judgment galiba is acquittal lang, acquitted na, so, simple lang. The court shall state whether the evidence of the prosecution absolutely failed to prove the guilt of the accused or merely failed to prove the guilt of the accused beyond reasonable doubt. So, mura na siya. In either case, judgment shall determine if the acts or omission from which the civil liability might arise did not exist. So, muna yung maingon lang dahil ang judge that the accused is acquitted on the ground that the evidence presented by the prosecution cannot establish his guilt beyond reasonable doubt. So ordered. So kung ikaw ang accused nila, pakpak juga. Di man ka mapriso. Then sir, kano sa galit to, unsa galit tong ground nga mandatory ang presence accused sa trial, sa korte? So arraignment, trial for identification, and kanina yun, ay katulo. Muna yung ako sa inyo, judgment. Muna na siya. The judgment is promulgated by reading in the presence of the accused. Sumo na siya. That is why kung atong isimplify ang pangutan na what are instances where the accused present is mandatory in court. So, of course, from this section, nakita na to in the promulgations of judgment. Diba? But take note, ingon siya, however, if conviction is for light offense, so bantayan na to, na exception, the judgment may be pronounced in the presence of his counsel or representative. Muna ingon nila, except for light penalties. Oh, so bantayan natin na siya. So again, the presence of the accused in the promulgations of judgment is mandatory except for light offenses or light penalty. Okay. So muna na ang summary dira. So contents of judgment in case of conviction. Yeah. the legal qualifications of the offense, the participation of the accused in the offense, the penalty imposed upon the accused, and the civil liability or damages. So take note the promulgations of judgment made in the presence of the accused, except light offenses. So what are dismissal may amount to an acquittal? So bantayan nato na siya. Muna nag-isigot ka ganina. Kung nag-file ka of demurrer to evidence, kung gi-grant, that is equivalent to acquittal. Diba? Kung nag-isigot ka dito sa motion proposed, so na itabo, that is based on the denial of right to speedy trial, that is equivalent to acquittal. So ato na siyang tanaw. Kung sa'yo may tabo de reserve, so ang case dili na pwede refile balik because it would now be ground or attached na ang double jeopardy. It's now barred by double jeopardy. Bay, paliog kog na mute sa kwan siguro bay na siguro wala na ka-mute dira. Lain man ang kwan. Lamuhi ko. Okay. Now, when judgment become final? When judgment become final? Okay. Una, after the lapse of the period for perfecting an appeal. So like for example, karon gibasahan ta ikaw, Mr. Abraham Murong, nakit ang sadaan sa pagpagawat. Ikaw pagapresuhon sa duha ka tuig ngadto na sa unom ka tuig. Of course, so ordered. So unsa gali remedy nimo after judgment for conviction? Mananingon sila nga pwede ka mag file og motion for reconsideration, pwede ka mag-file og new trial, pwede po ka mag-appeal. Oh. So ang pangunta na dire is how long is the period of perfecting an appeal? So muna yung nato nga 15 days. So gikan karon so good tag count ugma, 1, 2, 3, ang tod 15 kadlaw. Now, ang pangunta na rin nato dire is that when judgment become final. So una, after the lapse of the period for perfecting an appeal. Muna akong gingon sa inyo nga, after the lapse of the period of 15 days. Okay. Ikaduha, di ba? When the sentence has been partially or totally satisfied or served. So that is judgment is final na. Iservisyuhan na gunin mo. When the accused has waived in writing his right to appeal. So muna ang ipangutan na dayon. Di ba? Gibasahan ta karon. Unsa may kasulti sa akusado. Oh, guilty man ang depensa. So muna ningon dayon ang abogado, judge, kontento na may sa decision. Di ba? So ang bot pasabot na na, so inyo nang gidawat ang sentensya. Ikaw akusado, imo nang gi-accept nga sadaan ka, imo na pong i-accept nga mapriso ka. Hmm. So, ang imong gibuhat, maingon na rin ka nga, judge, dili namin mo apilar. Amo nang iwib. So, kung sa may metabo, of course, the judge will issue a final, kung sa man, order for judgment of conviction para pwede na rin ka ibiyahe dito sa Bureau of Correction or sa jail as the case may be. Hmm. So, manayon niya, the accused waived in writing. Hmm. Then, ang ikaupat na manang nag-iskota ka, di ba? Oh. When judgment become final, so when the accused has applied for provision. Oh. Mamanang atong gisgotan gyapon kagapon, di ba? Oh. So nga kung nag-apply ka og provision, di ba? Sa hisgot, di ba? Nag-iskota gapon sa rule, sa rule 114, bill, di ba? Kanos sa pwede nga di ba? Dili na pwede mag-bail. Di ba? So, after final judgment, wala na bail. Pero kung nag-apply ka o probation, you are entitled to bail while your application is pending, di ba, before the court. So, in this case, kung nag-apply ka o probation, judgment become final and executory. Nga naman, because ang waiver, ang implication, mangodirabay, pag-apply na yung probation, it is deemed waiver of the right to appeal. Mabito na nag-apply ka o probation because most likely, you accept the penalty imposed. Imong gidawat. Muna nag-apply ka provision. So that is why when the accused applied for provision. Yeah, judgment become final and executory. That is why, muna inyong bantayan ba, nga pangutana sa board exam ba ya? Kung maingon nga, what is the effect if the accused applied for provision? Of course, it is them. We bear the right to appeal. Therefore, judgment become final and executory. Okay. So, muna na inyong itawag na to nga appeal. Diba? Muna mo balik ka, kung mag-isgot kita rule, sa appeal, mubalik ka dito sa itong discussion sa jurisdiction. Oh. Muna naingon sila, who may appeal? Of course, the party may appeal from judgment or final order. Unless the accused will be placed in double jeopardy. Kaya di naman ginis siya. So, of course, most likely, ang mag-appealar dila is ang akusado involving criminal cases. Where to appeal? So, muna yung bantayan na. Muna rin ni Derek, katotong may ngunta, notice of appeal, petition for review, petition for certiorari. Now, take note. Cases kung naisabol by MTC to the RTC. Cases kung naisabol by the RTC to the CE. Cases kung naisabol by the CE to the Supreme Court. Muna yung niya, to the Regional Trial Court in cases decided by Metropolitan Trial Court, Municipal Circuit Trial Court, Municipal Trial Court, or Municipal Circuit Trial Court. So, to simplify, whether MTC, MCTC, di ba? MCTC, di ba? Oh, that is to the RTC. So, to simplify, cases cognizable by MTC or not more than 6 years is appealable to the RTC through notice of appeal. So, naingon na po din siya sa letter B. To the Court of Appeal or to the Supreme Court in per cases provided by law in cases decided by the RTC. So, mo naingon nila, kung sa man ang example to the Supreme Court, di ba, nag-isgo taga itong Monday, nga kung what if, sir, kung ang involving death penalty. So, natin, gitawag na automatic review. So, diretso ka Supreme Court. So, that is why, example lang, gicharged tag homicide, convicted ta og homicide, RTC. So, ang nai-appellate jurisdiction, ang CE. Then, of course, to the Supreme Court in cases decided by the Court of Appeal. So, munang pag-abot sa CE by, so, gi-affirm ang decision. So, most likely, wala tayo remedy. Convicted yamon na. So, ang atong remedy is na ataad ta Supreme Court. So, munang yung nga, to the Supreme Court in cases decided by the Court of Appeal. That is why you have to be remember because in the board exam, possibly man, maingon siya, ang kaso decided by the Court of Appeal in their appellate jurisdiction is appealable to what court? Of course, to the Supreme Court. So, bantayan niyo na siya. Ang pangutana na lang dayan dira is unsay mood sa appeal. So, muna yung bantayan na. How appeal is taken? Okay. The appeal to the Regional Trial Court or to the Court of Appeal in the cases decided by the Regional Trial Court in the exercise of its original jurisdiction, oh, klaro kayo na, shall be taken by filing of notice of appeal. So, bantayan na yung mga pag original jurisdiction, notice of appeal. With the court which rendered judgment or final order appealed from or by serving a copy thereof upon the adverse party. Oh, so, maray nang ingon na niya, sa letter B, the appeal to the Court of Appeal in cases decided by the RTC in the exercise. So, munang pag original ang jurisdiction, notice. Pero exercise na gali sila in appellate jurisdiction, so munang makadungog dahil ka nga, shall be by petition for review. Oh, so na implication. Muna kung maingon gali, unsa implication, sir, kung ang gifile sa appeal, sir, is petition for review. So most likely, that is in the exercise of their appellate jurisdiction. Okay. So muna na yung bantayan. The appeal to the Supreme Court in cases where the penalty imposed by the Regional Trial Court is reclusion perpetua or life imprisonment or where illicit penalty is imposed but for offenses committed on the same occasion or which arouse out of the same occurrence that give rise to most serious offense for which the penalty of death, reclusion perpetua or life imprisonment is imposed shall be filing of a notice of appeal in accordance with paragraph 1 and section to. So, ang procedure lang na siya. Oh. So, naingon na siya sa letter D, no notice of appeal is necessary in case where death penalty is imposed by the Regional Trial Court. Kano man, mo ito nag-discuss ta sa Monday nga automatic review. Mo naingon niya, the same shall be automatically reviewed by the Supreme Court as provided in section 10 of this rule. So, ang procedure. Oh. So, mo naingon na siya, except as provided in the last paragraph of section 13, Rule 124, all other appeals to the Supreme Court. So, muna na ingunan ko sa inyo nga, by petition for review on certiorari under Rule 45. So, manang imong bantayan nila, unsay implication sa notice of appeal, unsay implication sa petition for review, unsay implication for petition for review on certiorari. So, take note of that. Oh. So, manang gikan sa MTC, pildi ka convicted, file ka og notice of appeal sa MTC para i-forward ang record sa RTC. Ang RTC, nag-exercise og appellate jurisdiction. Gi-affirm ang decision. So, wala gyapon ka ni kontento. So, naingon ka nga imong i-elevate sa CA. So, ang imong i-file, dili na notice kay, ang jurisdiction sa RTC is appellate naman. So, mo nang makadungog rin kag-petition for review. Di ba? Mm-hmm. Dayon, ang kaso karon is gi-decisionan sa appellate court, gi-affirm. So, wala na kay mahimo, maadto kag Supreme Court. So, unsa na may imong mood, mo nang makadungog na rin ka nga, petition for review on certiorari. So, ato na lang kito bagbay. When appeal to be taken? So, klaro na kayo na. 15 days. From the promulgations of judgment. Or from the notice of final order appealed from. So, ayun nagkagula na ba? Kalimti? The period for perfecting an appeal shall be suspended from the time a motion for new trial or reconsideration is filed until notice of order overruling the motion has been served. Of course, wala may problema kay inani man siya pag convicted ka, dili man kay appeal ang imong remedy na may MR, motion for reconsideration or notice petition for new trial. So ang imong buhaton nira is kano sa imong i-file, so within 15 days. So bantayan na to na. Then of course nanay summary. Kung may appeal, of course, any party. Original jurisdiction, notice of appeal. Appellate jurisdiction, petition for review or petition for certiorari. Note, kanusa nimo i-appeal within 15 days after promulgations of judgment. Then, of course, just for purposes of discussion, what are the grounds of new trial, errors of law, or irregularities prejudicial to the substantive rights of the accused? Oh. Pag may nga errors of law by, wala na yung magigamit, wala na yung mag-question nga convicted ka, kundili ang sayop sa pag-apply sa bilhag. Or, kung dili man galing, natay new and material evidence has been discovered. Then, grounds for reconsideration. So, mag-file ka og MR, manang gitawag na motion for reconsideration. So, errors of law in the judgment. Or, kung dili man galing errors of law, errors of fact in the judgment. So, muna ito man. So, that will end our discussion. Di ba? So, nangigsoon, wala mo yung mga pangutana? Sa yung mga pangutana kay atong tubagon.